if it doesn't.
Hold on to your butts.
Don't waste my motherfucking time!
I got up this morning. Put on my shoes. Tied my shoes. Went to the mirror. Put a comb in my hair. I made a move. Oh, what to do?
Welcome, everybody, to the Lotus Cast. My good friend Joe's here. Hey, Joe.
Hi, Matt.
My other pal, Adam. How you doing, Adam?
Hey there.
Oh, boy.
Hi, everybody.
A really just great episode for you tonight. We have really done a lot of show prep. We've come up with so many topics, and we've got some stuff that's going to really keep you guys on the edge of your seats. You're going to be wanting to call in and chime in. The chat's going to be hustling and bustling.
And we are set up for all of that. We're set up for the calls in and the chats and the hustling and bustlings.
So much going on. So welcome. You know, it's going to be a good episode. So first things that I want to address and I want to talk about is Logan.
Logan. Has anybody seen that yet?
Logan, the movie with Wolverine. Last week, you know, I gave it a pretty, like, I loved the movie, I really did, and I realized afterward, after the show, I was a little harsh on it. I was a little rough on the movie.
I didn't know you were. I think you had some.
You didn't think I was?
I think you had some fair criticisms, and I feel like because you sort of bashed it, you felt like maybe you didn't say enough good things about it.
No, I feel a little hypocritical about some of my insults towards Logan.
Why?
I heard Logan feels bad about what you said.
You think so?
Why are you hypocritical about, like, pointing out some of the movie's flaws?
So here's the deal. I have always kind of bashed comic book movies for going in and doing too much backstory rather than just telling a story, because there's so many great comics that they just kind of pick up somewhere. They give you a brief backstory, but not too much, and then that's you're actually just following the story. And I've always said, oh man, they always have to explain or over explain stuff, and that's what a lot of comic, that's where they fail, is they over explain stuff. And I think Logan actually did succeed in the fact that they didn't have to. It was like, all right, well, we've got some hints as to why. You figure that out on your own. And I was fine with
didn't,
that, actually.
I mean, technically, you don't ever have to, but it's nice when they do, so they don't feel like plot holes. Like, why did this happen? Like, can you at least
But I don't really think they were plot holes. I don't think they were plot holes because they left it. Like, they just said, hey, we'll they did toy around with it. It's not like they ignored it.
Like, you can't just speak in, well, you know, you can't speak in generalities here. Like, what things in particular were you glad they didn't mention?
What the mutants kind of disappearing. They I think addressed that.
They did explain it.
The X-Men dying.
They don't say yes whether or not they do.
Yeah, but I'm fine with that. Like, do you understand where I'm coming from, Adam?
Yeah. Like, you trashed it on those topics, and now you feel bad.
But I feel like those weren't the only criticisms you had. You had some other very valid, legitimate criticisms.
Yeah, some of them I still feel the same way. But I'm just saying that those criticisms, I they weren't fair.
The one thing that you've just redacted.
That topic, yes, but the couple of items.
What other items are you redacting now?
The mutants
disappearing. That's one thing. It's that they didn't have to explain.
And the X-Men.
Yes, the one thing that they didn't have to explain.
That's two things. Those are two things.
Those aren't two separate things. That's under one topic. They don't have to explain their backstory. That's one topic. So are you redacting anything else?
Those are two separate things.
They're the same thing, though.
Those are things you wonder about, though. You don't go in there wondering, like, oh, how did Logan get metal claws?
Right.
Yes, but what I'm saying is that is one
topic.
But
they also toyed around with it. Like, they didn't just... They didn't beat you over the head with it. They said... They kind of loosely explained it. The other thing was who they were running to in Canada. So it's three things. Those three things I'm okay with. I'm okay being left where we were with the movie.
But basically one topic you're redacting, that they don't have to inform you on.
I don't understand.
Things. Your original criticism was that they didn't inform you about certain things. And so all of the three things you listed, that's part of the original criticism of they didn't inform
me. I don't understand why you're lumping them all into one thing here.
Because this is the only thing you're redacting is that they didn't have to explain things.
Okay. All right. So if you want to get this deep in it, yes, I'm redacting one thing, Joe.
Yes.
That's how you want to
view
this.
That's how I want to view this. Because
all right, you can view it as that. That's fine.
Joe, why do you have to argue semantics and just derail conversation?
I'm not derailing. He's trying to criticize something. I'm trying to help him criticize it accurately and fairly.
We understood what he was saying.
He's being a cunt.
You're being
what
a cunt
being right now.
I feel
he's
like
definitely being a cunt.
I mean, don't just let the cunt word fly. I mean, we are giving it power here. I don't.
Adam, would you agree that Joe's being a cunt right now?
Wholeheartedly.
I feel like all of you are being cunts, and I'm justified in calling you a cunt.
Whoa, Joe.
What?
What the hell?
What the hell? You called me a cunt, cunt lips.
You can't just throw that word around.
Well, you are, and I learned by watching you.
I didn't say it once. I just agreed with Matt that you are.
You said it six times. I heard it.
Can you get our guest on the line, please?
He or she is not responding.
Oh, weird. That's not true. Hello?
No, I mean, we're not connected. He's not responding. She's not responding.
She?
He or she. I mean, it's still a surprise.
He, she?
He, she's not responding.
Shemp?
Shemp Howard?
So, but yeah, that's where I stand. And I it wasn't as terrible as I lambasted it as last
I don't think
I
it's... yeah, he, she did not respond. I don't think it's unfair to like criticize a film that has some very valid criticisms. It's just we tend to focus on those things more because those are the things that stick out in your mind. Like, you're not going to have a long essay on like what great cinematography it had, which it didn't, but like you have a lot of thoughts on like, this is what they could have done differently. This is what they should have done differently.
What was wrong with the cinematography?
It was fine. It wasn't like anything outstanding.
What would have made it spectacular?
I don't know. It just felt like a fairly straightforward, you know,
more Dutch angles.
Could have literally done anything with it, which didn't really happen at all. It was fairly straightforwardly shot. I mean, it was fine.
Do you want to amend your score you gave the movie, Matt?
What did I give it? I think I gave it a 4.5, right?
I gave it a 4 out of 5. I said, like, even though I had some criticisms that we talked about at length, I still thought it was a good movie, and I gave it a 4 out of 5.
Yeah, I'll keep it at a 4.5. I'm not gonna go any higher or lower. I think 4.5 is pretty high. Pretty good score for Logan.
I'll change mine to a perfect 5 out of 7.
I feel like actually that lowers it. If you did that.
So I guess I guess we should address the elephant in the room, or well, not in the room, I guess. We're missing our longtime listener. Michelle's not in our chat room.
I heard we're not her favorite podcast anymore.
Yeah, my good buddy Michael Moore from the Wheelbarrow Full of Dicks program on Monday nights informed me that she mentioned in their chat room. This starts to get to where it sounds so petty. It's like, oh, he told me in their chat room that this person was saying this.
I was just about to say, like, I really don't care.
So I guess, well, I mean, all this stuff is happening, and she's been such a long time listener. Michelle has listened for,
I know, but that, like,
years.
That's such like a petty little thing. Like, if she's listened for years, she knows how much abuse me in particular has taken from the show. Like, and you can't handle like 1 second. What is happening?
What is that?
It's our guest somehow added he or she to the show and is now putting on a microphone or something.
God, have your shit together.
Seriously.
Yeah, mute that person.
I can't. I can hang up. That's all I can do.
Hello? All right, hang up. It's terrible.
What, you didn't want to watch he, she put on glasses?
I didn't even see video.
Oh.
He, she put on glasses. But yeah, Michelle has been a longtime listener of the show. And I do agree with you, Joe. She has listened to us berate each other, and mainly you, for years and years and years. Before we go any further, last week on the show, I don't even really remember. I just know that she said something about the show not being that great, and I called her a cunt for it. That's what happened. She said she left, and I was like, okay, whatever. And then she goes on to our friend's podcast, Wheelbarrow Full of Dicks, and says in their chat room that we're not her favorite anymore.
Were we ever her favorite?
Not going to be in the chat room, which is like, ooh, well, whoa now.
Does that mean she's still listening? Or? Oh,
I got the comments here. So we talked about Logan the whole episode, which she didn't enjoy.
Yeah.
And then,
right, because she's not a comic book fan.
And then you said something, I forget what, but she said, God forbid someone say something not nice about an episode, not stroking Matt's ego enough. And then that's when you said it.
So it seems like she's just upset solely at Matt and like Adam and I.
So I don't think that the sole reason why she's mad is because I called her a cunt. I feel like there's something else. You don't go from listening again. I feel like we've been down this road with her before. I think we've danced around the cunt word, and her
this
listening.
Can't have been
and,
the worst thing that you've ever said to her, can it?
What makes me like?
Wait, are you saying
I don't
this
believe
from our guest?
No,
you don't see the video.
Hold on. I gotta accept the video.
It's just he, she pacing around in the background. Like, not even listening or talking.
I don't understand what's happening.
You want me to hang up again?
Yeah, I can't. I can't just...
Can you guys hear me all right?
No, you sound echoey as shit.
Finally found the mic.
See, he, she couldn't even find the mic.
Is your microphone a tin can and a string?
Why were you not ready to go?
Yeah. You realize you're interrupting the show and all we could hear is like you messing around in the background. Why would you call if you weren't even ready? I don't know.
He doesn't.
Okay, I'm going to hang up on him. He's walking around in the background again.
Those visual effects. Those visual responses.
Okay, yeah.
Hang up.
I hung up.
Damn it.
I can't. Whatever he, she is doing, it's ridiculous.
So she's, I don't think that that's what she's really upset about. I think there's more, there's something deeper than this. Because the deal is we've thrown that word around so much and we've said such terrible things about everybody. And what else do you expect? And on top of that, I mean, she's the first one to attack us and call us assholes and dicks and pile on whenever. Like, if we're doing a attack Joe bit, I mean...
She's the first one to hop into that.
That's what I've always felt. So I don't understand why she's... You know, again, I think there's something deeper. There's something else that
I think
really
she's just
bothering
mad
her
at you. She's not mad at Adam or myself, I don't think.
Probably not. And I mean...
I did comment on her Facebook post about watching The Vampire Diaries, but she didn't respond to it.
Oh.
Oh, maybe she's
on the shit list.
Yeah, maybe. So maybe I made it to the shit list. But I really did believe Stelena forever, so I don't know.
Adam, do you have any insight? You're a close friend of Michelle's.
I haven't talked to her in a few weeks.
Ooh, so there's a rift between you two that she's taking out on Matt and me.
If there is.
And Vampire Diaries.
I didn't know about it, but there might be.
Oh. So it's a deep hole. We
actually
don't know who...
I didn't think about it, but now that I think about it, you know, I probably would have gotten a text after the show like, oh, God, Matt's such an asshole.
Yeah.
But I didn't even get that.
Is it because maybe when I called her a cunt, you laughed?
Did I? I don't think I did.
I don't know. I think I don't remember it.
I was pretty quiet during that. I didn't want to get involved.
You were silently
agreeing.
Well,
you seemed to know her plans, though. You said that she was in Medway tonight.
Yeah, I do know. I was invited to the same event she was invited to.
Oh. Yeah, should we try to call her and get this in?
I think she's... Oh, I don't know. I don't think she would respond. We're failing so much on the phone calls these days. Like, the only successful one we had was Jay Burns.
That one went without a hitch. The one tonight is not working out at all.
I don't know, Matt.
No.
You do get pretty nasty. Like, you jump straight to very resentful comments.
Yeah, you go from, like, 1 to 100 on, like, on the scale. Like,
that is what I do, for sure. And I wouldn't say it's resentful. I would just say I'm being a dick.
But, I mean, like, you'll be fine. And then you'll just see... You'll, like, see someone just doing something. You're like, oh, I hate that. I'm going to say something awful about it.
Yeah, like, yeah, you don't even...
being cocksuckers.
Yeah, you don't even say something, like, mildly, like, nice about it. Or not even nice, but, like, you just jump straight to cocksucker. You'd be like, oh, that's a cocksucker thing to do. Not,
yeah,
like, that's like,
big,
a dumb thing to do, you know? You don't lessen the hit. You just hit it with the full nuke.
Like, when you see something that irritates you, do you just get this twinge that says, like, oh, I have to tear that down straight away?
I wouldn't say that it's really a what did you say, a twinge?
Yeah, like just a knee-jerk reaction.
No, I more so just do it, just to do it. It makes me laugh. I find humor in it.
But, when you said the C word last week, it did sound pretty nasty the way you said it.
Oh, I honestly, I don't know. If you would say that it sounded nasty, I was probably intended it to sound nasty. It wasn't. I intended it to sound nasty, but again, it's just kind of a joking, just busting balls type of feeling. That's how I feel. I'm just busting her balls. She felt as though, hey, I'm gonna bust their balls, and I'm like, okay.
Yeah, but like she said, you know, like, oh, the show's not great, and then you jumped straight like to like the worst thing you can say to a woman.
First of all, I don't agree with that. That's a retarded thing to say.
What's the worst thing that you can say to a woman?
No, it's just these are words. If you put any stock into any particular word, you are a fucking idiot, and that's just the way it is.
I resent that she can just add he or herself to this conversation whenever she wants.
I agree with that.
I don't know.
Just a word like that shouldn't bother anyone. If it was like a personal attack, like about her.
Yeah, I mean, like, exactly. Like, if
this is
a headset now with blinking blue lights, and there's a microphone. She's just
blowing into the microphone.
Where do you find a pillow like that? It's just so small.
Can you stop touching the microphone?
Yeah, you can't. You gotta talk into the microphone. It's too far.
Yeah, don't hit it with your hand. Just talk into it.
Don't. And you're just coughing now. What are you? You got the plague or something? What is happening here?
Why was this a good idea?
What is he drinking? Is that Hulk Hogan's penis? That was a thermos. That was a huge.
This is too
I don't
much.
Know where I got the pillow, but it works all right.
Hello, Uncle Hall. How are you?
How are you?
I'm good. Now, hold on. We're going to get back to you. We're going to get to you in a second. You sit there and be quiet for a minute.
All right.
Stop touching your mic. Just leave it.
Stop touching the microphone. Did he unplug the microphone?
He unplugged the microphone. So now he's going to have to plug it back in, and we're going to have to hear that noise.
I know. He's okay. It's his birthday. His birthday was on Sunday. So this is why we're entertaining his little needle microphone and his dumb pillow and that thermos cock size thing that he's drinking out of. Anyway, Adam, as you were saying, like, yeah, that's, or as we were going back and forth here, I mean, there's nothing. Again, I've said terrible things to Joe.
Yeah, absolutely awful. Like,
I mean, it doesn't, when you listen to a show like that, okay, I feel like, oh, this is how they are. And you know, I'm like, these are jokes. We're just having fun. We're having fun.
You don't know it's jokes, though, when it, like, it's directed at you, because it feels pretty intensely hateful.
Well maybe, but I feel
it gets feeling pretty bad, too, just like she is now.
He does, but at the same time, like, that is in this this little arena of talk and vile terribleness. That's what we've been doing for how many years now?
Too many.
One, two, maybe.
So I mean, if you're gonna get, you know, offended by any of it, it's kind of on you at this point. It's like going to a comedy show and knowing that person.
What are you trying to do? Are you trying to? Are you trying to assuage her anger at this? Because, like, basically you're just saying, like, I'm going to be a dick. I'm not going to apologize for it. It's on you if you want to come back or not. Like, I'm not going
to. But you will apologize to Logan for being too harsh.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. I was too harsh on Logan. But I mean, Logan didn't deserve that.
Even though, like, you've listened to me for years be a dick to everyone. So, like, when it's directed at you, I don't understand why you're upset. So, I don't care. I don't care if you come back or not. Oh, you want me to call her?
Should we call her?
You think she'll answer? I mean, I would definitely. I don't think she will.
Hang on, I'll call her. Let's see if she answers.
We'll try. I mean, part of it too was she couldn't defend herself on the air, like you were talking about her on the air. But if we call her,
yeah. I mean, again, if you're gonna come into, what is that?
It's Uncle Hall plugging his mic back in.
Oh. If you're gonna, you know, come into a chat room and then say those things, then I mean,
all right,
not stroking your ego enough.
That's right, need my ego stroked, buddy.
That's the biggest defense here, really. I mean, she should be apologizing for that.
I could be fast on the hang up in case it goes
for not stroking now. My ego. Yeah, you're right, she should be apologizing to me for not.
Hello.
Hi, I'm Michelle.
Hey, Michelle.
Who is this?
That's your buddy.
Oh, she just hung up. I feel like she didn't know who it was. So you didn't clarify that it's the Lotus Cast.
I kind of thought, you know, one of you guys were gonna pipe up, but then you guys just stayed quiet, like you were.
Well, I wanted to see where it was going.
Yeah. Wanted to hear what you would say. You call her back?
I gotta agree.
Maybe you should talk to her, Uncle Hall.
Fine.
He'll take this burden, this responsibility.
You're gonna be the mediator.
I will.
Well, now I feel like she won't answer.
Hi, you've reached Michelle's cell phone. I can't...
Michelle?
I went straight to voicemail.
She turned it off. She's not.
Adam, can you facilitate this? Can you text her and just be like, it's us calling?
I don't want to get in the middle of this. I have to see her.
He has to deal with her. I don't know, man. I just think that it's like if you go to a water park and you get upset that you got wet, you know, it's on you. But
what if I just want to get my feet wet, not my hair?
Well, if you stand too close to the Splash Mountain ride, your hair's going to get wet. Uncle Hall?
Yes.
How are you, buddy?
Do you have any insight on this, Jack? Has she talked to you at all?
I've never actually spoken with her outside of the chat room, so I wouldn't know.
All right, well, that sums it up right there.
Yep.
Thanks for your insight.
Crazy good insight coming from Uncle Hall. Uncle Hall, how old are you now? I think it's still 15. Illegal.
What was that? Jeez, Uncle Hall.
You need to
I'm old enough to drive.
You need to not exhale. Uncle Hall,
don't breathe into your microphone. Just no breathing from now on.
But I got to be baby Robin, man. Roman's not here, so someone's got to take up his position.
No, nobody does.
nobody needs that in their life.
Agrees.
What? I'm sorry. Stop touching your mic.
You know, Anchor in the chat's right. You can't make an omelet without breaking some eggs. And we broke some Shell's eggs, I guess.
Should we leave her a voicemail?
No, because that might her number wouldn't pop up, would it? I don't want that to happen.
Well, no, she said this is Michelle's voicemail and leave a message.
That's true. Yeah. Yeah, Anchor's completely right. If you hang out in the barbershop long enough, you're going to get your hair cut. So this is some great analogies coming from Anchor.
Hi, you've reached Michelle's cell phone. I can't get to the phone right now, so please leave a message and I'll call you back. Thanks.
Is her name really Michelle?
At the tone, please record your voice message. When you are finished recording, you may hang up or press pound for more options.
Oh, you're not leaving a message?
Hi, Michelle. It's me. It's your friend, Matt.
And me. I'm also here.
Uncle Hall here apparently needs to tell you that he's here. He's just clamoring for that attention. I think Joe's here.
Hi, Michelle. I just wanted to say...
Adam's off in the corner.
That Adam gave us your number, so...
Whoa.
Wait. You...
Just throw me under the bus, Joe.
I'm sorry.
Maybe call us back, you know, if you know...
But I only did it because I wanted to facilitate a friendship between the two of you once
also,
again.
Also, I think we've come to the conclusion that it's your fault you're offended, so... I don't think that's the right conclusion,
but as somebody who's been on the other end of that, I don't think that's the right conclusion.
It's a sticky wicket.
I love that you and Dave would always say that, like, oh, this is basically your fault for having emotions. If you were just emotionless like us.
Don't even go there.
Yeah.
That's
always the case. It's like, well, I can't control how my words make you feel. I shouldn't have to feel bad about this.
That is exactly that is how this works.
Yes.
That is the world.
It is your fault for having emotions. Don't be like, you should be a soul, like, dead inside person like me.
The fact is, you never look at yourself to say, maybe I should control my emotions.
No, I don't think that myself or Michelle should have to apologize for having emotions.
I never ask Michelle to apologize. I'm just, and in fact, I am apologizing to Michelle that she feels this way.
Yeah, it's kind of on you for feeling this way, even though I'm the one that caused it.
I mean, just you reaching out like this is kind of showing an apology.
Yeah, I'm sorry that she is uninsufferable. Okay, I can't do that. It's
you put more of an effort into your apology for Logan than you can for this. Michelle, our longest listener.
I'm really sorry for the things that I said about Logan last week. I Logan did not deserve that.
Poor Michelle.
Well, Michelle.
Hey Adam, I just posted an article in the chat. I think you'll like it.
You can call us back.
All right, let me step away from the show to read an article.
Yeah, all right, hang up on Michelle, I guess.
Okay. Well, if she's not listening to the show, she might want to listen on her voicemail later.
That is true. I guess we could keep... Is that her voicemail just a, like...
It's not hung up on us yet, so...
That is kind of crazy, right?
Let's fill it up.
Like, maybe it has a limit, like, after 2 minutes or something, it just disconnects, but we haven't
hit it
yet.
I feel like we've been going for 2 minutes.
Yeah, see, well, I guess we'll... Anger said, wow, you're terrible at apologies, so you did an awful job, Matt.
I mean, again, I said that I was sorry that she felt like I was attacking her, which I did attack her, but I'm sorry that she was offended, that she felt she should have been offended.
Uncle Hall, can you unplug your mic, please, and don't plug it back in for the rest of the show?
It is really terrible. I
can you not breathe into it, or, you know, I don't know, do something else with it.
You know, we had Uncle Hall on here because it is Joe Appreciation Week. The only person that remembers Joe Appreciation Week is Uncle Hall. He's the only one that remembers. He's the only one that cares. I mean, honestly, the bit itself wasn't good. There was a reason why we weren't going back to it.
Because nobody can say anything nice about me.
It's his birthday, and I felt like, you know what? He's such a good listener, and Uncle Hall, I'm sorry that we didn't get around to this bit. I do apologize to you for that.
I don't care. You know. I only use it to make fun of jokes.
You have reached the maximum time permitted to record. To send your message, press 1 at any time. To listen to your message, press 2.
You gotta press 1.
To re-record, press 3. For more options, press 4. To cancel, press star.
What are you doing?
I pressed 1. Does that work?
I don't know.
No hablo inglés.
I'm just hanging up now. Hopefully she gets it.
I hope so. Maybe we'll call her back in like 5 minutes or something after she listens to that. Maybe we'll just leave her the whole show in little voicemail clips. All 2 hours.
Yeah, I'm sure she won't.
It's so convenient.
Yeah.
Here, let's call her back. Call her back right now. Let's get into the voicemail. And
all right.
Okay, yeah. Sorry, guys. We're going to put the show on hold here for a little bit so that Michelle
can receive her apology.
We don't want her to miss anything, you know? Like, if she's not in the chat room, she's upset at me. So.
I mean, you had her for a second, and then, yeah.
Uncle Hall, do you have any appreciative comments for our friend Joe?
I love how you have an absolute abhorrence of describing hair color.
Hi, you've reached Michelle's cell phone. I can't get to the phone right now, so please leave a message and I'll call you back. Thanks.
At the tone, please record your voice message. When you are finished recording, you may hang up or press pound for more options.
And we are live. It is the Lotus Cast, lotuscast.com, coming at you right here on Michelle's voicemail. Uncle Hall is joining us as a guest. He's got some sort of snack now. Motherfucker cannot sit down for 2 seconds. He has to run around and just make the worst noise. Like, you do realize that this transcribes terribly on our show, right?
I don't think he does.
I know. Yeah, I know.
And let it be known that I just called Uncle Hall a motherfucker. Uncle Hall, I apologize that if that offended you. I'm sorry.
I don't care.
Just letting you know. Just letting you know. Anyway, what were we talking about? Joe.
Yeah.
What was that? What did you say?
I didn't get it. He said something
about the hair color?
I'm terrible at describing hair colors. I didn't realize that was a thing.
No one remembers this.
Damn old people. Can you repeat it?
Yeah.
Can you repeat it again?
What aren't we just remembering?
You are the official Lotus Cast historian.
I think it was the episode. Let me check. I have my notes here.
Oh, I see.
He took notes?
He took notes the first show.
Dude, he's got a fucking notebook in front of him where he's got everything written. Do you write stuff down that we say?
Yeah.
My God.
Oh, this is not
Uncle
good.
Hall, I think we need to stop doing the show on your behalf.
Wait, do you write fan fiction about us doing stuff?
No.
Have you paired us off in your mind?
God, no.
Have you ever written a fan fiction where Adam jerked off into my chest hair and then as
it
dried?
It was Cuckold Sanders.
You have notes from Cuckold Sanders all the way back there?
You have.
Oh no, I have notes all the way back from Powerball Z.
How old are these episodes?
I don't even know what happened on Powerball Z. What happened on Powerball Z?
Yeah, it was an Oscars episode. Who remembers those?
But not the latest Oscar episodes. And you do, clearly.
Can we let him post these notes on the website?
Yeah. I need these notes.
Hey, just give me a tab.
Joe, hold on, Joe.
What?
You know what this reminds you of, right? This is fucking... He's our Bobo.
He is our Bobo.
He's sitting in his car writing notes. Thinking about questions that he can ask the Lotus Cast.
Oh, here we go. Cuckold Sanders is from July 14th of last year.
When is Powerball Z from?
I don't know.
January 14th of last year.
It is.
Uncle Hall, I'm really worried about you, buddy. I didn't realize you were listening to the show in this detail.
Dude, I've got over a gigabyte of the podcast saved on my phone.
What?
Why?
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 No reason. No reason whatsoever.
Like, are you just randomly checking in and listening to past episodes?
Yeah.
Do you like this much?
Yes.
Do you have a favorite episode?
My Thursday nights.
Yeah, what's your favorite episode?
Favorite episode.
Is it the one where we called Michelle a
great listener? Don't say we. A great listener.
When I called Michelle a great listener?
Honestly speaking,
you have reached the maximum time permitted to record. To send your message, press 1 at any time. To listen to...
I'm just hanging up.
So yeah, we got to call her back. We can't really continue the show unless...
Well, I got to find her again. She hasn't sent you any messages, right, Adam?
But yeah, the 2015 no. Thanksgiving episode behind
Uncle
that
Paul,
would have to
I be. Said, don't continue the fucking show until we are back on Michelle's voicemail.
Hands up, don't shoot.
That's right. Are we calling her back?
Yeah, it's ringing.
Oh, it's ringing. Oh, is she
not in? Hi, you reached Michelle's cell phone.
Nice.
I can't get to the phone right now, so please leave a message and I'll call you back. Thanks.
So it's actually ringing before...
At the tone, please record your voice message.
Huh.
When you are finished recording, you may hang up or press pound for more options.
All right, welcome back. It is the Lotus Cast. We are back from break. Hope you enjoyed that. We still have Uncle Hall in studio. Adam, oh man, what a great last bit that was. Whew.
We were just about to find out what Uncle Hall's favorite episode was.
That's what I know.
You said it like three times.
What is it?
I know, but Uncle Hall,
I can only imagine what notes are you going to write about this episode? I somehow ruined the episode.
Okay, Uncle Hall, what was your favorite episode?
2015 Thanksgiving's episode, followed up by the It Came From Another Podcast episode.
Oh, so you,
oh, It
you...
Came From Another Podcast was a good
Second.
Episode.
Yeah.
That was, we had Nate Laura and Jay Burns on, and I actually just remember most of that episode laughing. Those two together were so funny, and they were so fast and quick, and just I was laughing nonstop. My sides really hurt after that one.
Yeah.
The 2015 Thanksgiving episode was the one where you guys told me to kill myself, and I woke up to a bunch of messages that was, please don't kill yourself, from Mike
from
Morris.
Michelle, of all people.
And Michelle. Everybody, except the people on the show who said to kill yourself.
Oh, wait, hold on. Did Michelle tell you to kill yourself?
No. Michelle told him to not kill
yeah,
himself.
Yeah, I woke up to tweets and messages from like Mike Moore and Michelle saying, don't kill yourself.
And
do you think she rescinds those remarks?
Michelle, didn't she say you were a bully, Matt?
I've been called that before. It's not the first time I've heard that I've been a bully. Adam, would you consider me a bully?
Well, I said you were resentful earlier.
I don't understand the resentful. I'm not resenting anybody. There's nobody here that I'm resenting. They haven't done anything to me that I'm dwelling on.
Exactly.
I don't understand.
It's like nobody's done anything to you specifically, but you react harshly.
It is true.
Anchor in the chat says, since women don't like the Lotus Cast already, Shannon, two Shannons, Michelle and Canadian. I think we've...
I forgot about Canadian.
I don't think Canadian...
Is Canadian a real person?
Hold on. Canadian and Goldie...
Can we settle that debate?
...are fans of Dave and will not be back here until Dave returns. That day ever comes. Shannon, yes, we did end her podcasting career. Now, the other Shannon, our Shannon, the one that was on our show, that's not, that relationship is still, we're
yeah, we're still
good
friends
with Shannon.
Shannon. Yeah, she just chooses not to be on the show or listen to the show
she's
or
smart.
The show.
She's smart enough to not be on the show.
I mean, to be fair,
I mean, don't blame her.
Oh, well, I think if we invited her, we're like, hey, come over and hang out with us on the show. I think she would. Okay, keep sipping there.
I was thirsty, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I think she would hang out with us, right? I think if you invited her, she would come over. Not every Thursday, but...
I don't know, because Brian wouldn't. Well, actually, he might now, but... yeah, maybe, actually. Maybe I could ask him.
I mean, I'm not saying invite them. Definitely don't invite them. They're terrible, but...
I think the last time Brian was on the show, he just played World of Warcraft the entire time. It did
that is. He, they were, yeah, he was downloading World of Warcraft. Uncle Hall, do you have any other terrible insults you'd like to throw at Joe?
Well, no. I don't think they were insults. It's Joe Appreciation Day.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, Joe Appreciation Day. So any appreciative comments?
I absolutely love Joe's Mexican heritage.
Oh, that's nice.
The Mexicans, they love me. They love my wall.
You have reached the maximum time permitted to record. To send your message, press 1 at any time.
Are we going to do this? Are we going to keep Connor up?
I mean, I don't know what else to do with our time here. I really don't.
Talk about Wildlands.
Or we could be calling Michelle back.
Hang on.
Because that is a better way to spend this time.
I like the calling Michelle option.
Adam, do you have any appreciative comments for Joe?
Joe, I really love the way you only argue semantics and always try to derail every conversation.
I wouldn't say it's every conversation.
Would you say that Joe's a cunt?
Now we've been banned from the voicemail. The call was declined.
Oh.
Oh, come on now. All right.
Wait, give me the number.
I'm not giving you the number.
No.
Wow, you actually drew the line.
Well, she's probably like, now I've got to sift through 15 minutes of voicemail.
Listen, the last person that needs to have Michelle's phone number is somebody who's archived the show in notebook format. Keeps a gig of the show on his phone.
Can you just read some of the notes? Like, how many notes are you taking per episode?
See,
do you have any notes from the election special?
Michelle's cell phone.
Oh,
I never actually saw the election special.
Please leave a message and I'll call you back. Thanks.
I never actually saw
at the
election
tone,
special.
Please record your voice message. When you are finished recording, you may hang up or press pound for more options.
We are back live. It is the Lotus Cast Thursday nights at the Lotus Cast on Twitter. Please make sure you check out strangelabel.com. Tons of great shows over there. Wheelbarrow Full of Dicks. What do we got? Furnacast was back this week. Check them out. Our good friends, Unfit for FM, they're not on Strange Label, but you can go to unfitforfm.com. These are all the favorite shows of Michelle. Make sure you check them out. Anyway, getting back into a topic here. I think I have a blessing to post the election special.
Oh, really?
Jim Chadman from Not Safe for Schoolers has said that we can release the election special.
What's happening?
Fuck are you laughing about?
Is he laughing or sneezing or dying or snorting?
Are you snorting something? I thought that the worst person to do a show with was Joe, but now.
Yeah.
No, it's always been me.
It's apparently has been you the entire
time. Is this your goal the whole time, to sabotage the episode by being on it?
Every episode I've been on.
Adam, do you feel that Uncle Hall is the best or worst guess?
I mean, Uncle Hall is great, but I'm honestly not loving this.
Do you, who's better, Uncle Hall right now or 3 p.m.?
Uncle Hall. By far.
They were pretty terrible.
All right. I'll try and fix myself up. Let me just find this notes.
Let's listen to you troubleshoot the computer. And
Uncle Hall, what are your notes from the episode 55 Million Clam?
That was an episode we had?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was the first Joe Appreciation Week.
That was?
Oh, my God. I didn't even know that was one of our episodes. Like, that title.
55
why,
million
why
clam
was it called?
On March 10th of last year.
Why was it called
I don't know. You guys never even brought up a $55 million clam. Huh. I assume it was an axe to Harvey's headline.
To pull back the curtain a little bit, we often think about topics that we want to bring up.
But you never do.
and we don't get to them. And sometimes we're like, oh, that's a fun title. Because literally 10 minutes before the show, we're like, what should the title be? Now, most shows, they're smart about this, and they come up with a title after their episode, you know, because they can find something topical. We don't.
Yeah.
We find a title beforehand and then sometimes never get to the title.
And sometimes they're not even creative, like 55 Million Clam.
I really wish I knew why it was called 55 Million Clam.
We have one called.
I was hoping this episode would be called "Blame It on the Alcohol Too." Where's Michelle?
I mean, that was one of the options, but we went with a different one.
We sure did. Something okay. So yeah. What? Hold on. I actually really want to know what other episodes. Name another episode, Adam. That we can get notes from.
Joe wants his living room back.
The one where you ended the show.
Yeah, we were gone for a while.
Yeah, it was kind of a big jump. That was on April 7th.
You were
gone
for like 2 months.
We came back June 23rd.
Jeremy Furtado. I don't even remember who that was.
Jeremy Furtado.
He's a comedian.
He was a comedian, yeah.
Or, I mean, he still is. I follow him on Instagram.
April 18th. something about Deadpool.
Oh, yeah.
You only wrote something about Deadpool in it? That's your only note?
Yeah. Some of these episodes, I don't have like entire.
You have reached the maximum time permitted to record. To send.
Do you think that we?
She's probably pissed she can't get real voicemails at this point.
Honestly, nobody's leaving voicemails.
Do you think she's listening to the voicemails?
Well, she has to listen after we leave them, so she's probably still on voicemail 2 or 1.
If she's listening at all. She might just be deleting them. What is Uncle Hawk doing? He's just like in the background now.
Dude,
like,
I don't know. This kid is out of control. Like, he's all over the place.
He finally had something interesting where he's taking notes about the show and he can't even maintain an interest level
about
of it.
The notes.
We've been doing that the whole time.
Yeah. And then you stopped and then I walked
away.
Reached
Michelle's cell phone. I can't get to the phone right now.
Her voicemail sounds tired of us.
Leave a message and I'll call you back. Thanks.
It really does.
I don't know. Let's talk about Wildlands.
At the tone, please record your voice message. When you are finished recording, you may hang up or press pound for more options.
I'll be honest.
Pick up the phone, please.
I'll be honest with you, Uncle. I don't think anybody wants to hear us talk about Wildlands. I mean, I've enjoyed my time on Wildlands, but I don't think anybody gives a shit.
Yeah, generally our video games fall, or talk about video games fall pretty flat.
I mean, Adam's not even playing it.
I played the beta. I went to PAX East last weekend, and
how was PAX East?
It was good. I met the head developer for Mass Effect Andromeda, and I guess he worked on the old Mass Effects too. But apparently he's like some big deal, and I didn't know who he was. But I just went up to him, and I just like unloaded all the shit I hate about shooters in the past 10 years.
Including Mass Effect?
Yeah. I was like...
What did he say?
Was your face red afterwards?
No.
What'd he say?
I mean, he clearly didn't care, and he was just entertaining some weirdo who came up to him, but I was like, I hate third-person shooters. Why are they all over-the-shoulder perspective? Why can't your guy just be in the damn middle of the screen?
Exactly.
And he's like, I don't know why they're all over the shoulder now. It used to be like that. I'm like, well, change it back.
Change it back now.
I have no power to change this. I don't know why, but yeah, that's a good point, sir.
Adam, did you see a
he
lot
did have
of
the power? He makes a game.
Did you see a lot of cleavage?
There was some good cosplays, as Dave would call them.
Dave hates it when you call it cosplay.
They were wearing good cosplays.
I called them cosplay outfits once, and he nearly had an aneurysm.
There was only one girl that had some really nice butt cleavage. And
butt cleavage?
What was she dressed as?
Misty.
Misty from Pokemon?
Yeah.
Nice.
And she had butt cleavage?
Yeah, short shorts. The short jean shorts all up high with acting all cheeky.
Was she making the
did
poses?
Did you jerk off to it later?
No, I forgot to. But I did jerk off.
You forgot to?
It was on my to-do list, and I just didn't get to it.
I forgot to think about her when I was jerking off. I did jerk off to this one girl who was, they had, like, this setup where you had to, like, defuse a fake bomb, and you had, like, 2 minutes to defuse it, and while she was doing it, she had, like, a loose shirt, and I could kind of see her boobs. I thought about her.
You got off to that?
Yeah.
Did you have a cosplay outfit when you were there?
No. Oh. Fat nerd, that was my outfit.
Was that most people's outfit?
We did play D&D with, like, an official Dungeons & Dragons representative as the DM, and we just, like, tried to totally derail the game.
For Joe Appreciation Day, I would like to add, I really appreciate the fact that Joe will let me sleep on his couch.
Yeah. I got a message at, like, almost 6 a.m.
Wait, the same couch I'm sitting on now?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Gross. What did you do?
Matt slept naked on the couch.
I dumped a lot of farts into that
he
couch,
did.
Adam.
That the room smelled a lot.
There are some crumbs on the couch.
That's probably from Matt, too.
I didn't eat anything on that couch. Oh, wait, you gave me some cookies.
Yeah, like I said, it's from Matt, not from me. I got a message at, like, almost 6 a.m. from Matt that was just like, hey, Joe, do you mind if I come over tonight and sleep over? I was like, sure. This is the right time to do this.
It's not like you'd say no.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, it's so true. Like, Matt can come over whenever he wants. I'm not going to say no. It's just, it was 6 a.m. I'm still asleep, man.
What happened was, you know, the storm, this we had up in New England, we had a really big storm. And I was like, oh, shit. I want to go down, but I don't really want to drive back.
You have reached the maximum time permitted to record. To send your message.
I always hate that's so, like, it obnoxious. I wish we were just.
How can she interrupt going? Us like that?
Michelle is being very rude. In this episode, I don't understand why she's bothering us so much. She can't just let us do a show straight through. We have to call
her
back.
We could just, like,
again.
Fast forward through the voicemail.
I wonder if Unfit for FM is upset that WFOD is her favorite podcast and not Unfit for FM.
Yeah, I don't know. I do like that we, you know, we did push her to another podcast. Like, we I don't think Michelle would have ever listened to podcasts. No,
I will reached Michelle's cell phone. I can't get to the phone right now, so please leave a message and I'll call you back. Thanks.
At the tone, please record your voice message.
It takes
when
so
you are
long.
Finished recording, you may
forever.
Hang up or press pound for more options.
All right, we are back. It is the Lotus Cast. Getting ready for Harvey's headlines. So there was a big snowstorm in the area, and I was like, I didn't want to stay in the hotel two nights in a row, because I actually thought, maybe I'll go to Joe's and I'll play some video games with Joe. But that didn't happen, because all we did was eat Chinese food and then went over to his place. We started Assassin's Creed. 10 or 15 minutes in, we passed out like old people at like 9:15.
Yeah, it was bad.
Were you in each other's arms?
No. I would have been, though. He just wouldn't. He wouldn't have me.
Matt took the whole couch to himself. He wouldn't share it. I had to sit in my computer chair.
I did. As soon as we got back from the Lotus, like, I just sprawled out down on the couch. I was like, I moved my suitcase out of the couch and just crashed.
Yeah, Matt came over probably around 6 o'clock at night, or 6:30, somewhere around there. And we went over to the Lotus, like, right after then, and stayed there for two and a half hours, just eating and drinking. And then we came back here and, like, immediately went to bed.
We were watching the Lotus, for whatever reason, had Family Feud on the television.
Yeah.
And I haven't watched Family Feud. I only know from, like, the little clips that you get on Facebook, and they're like, oh, look how wacky Steve Harvey's being. But that show is fucking outrageous.
Yeah.
That show is so over the top. Like, they
just
were
the responses.
Saying one of the questions was, what on a lady do you want to be, like, super soft? Or, like, what do you want to have, like, a soft body part on a lady or something like that? I forget the question. But the guy answered, her butt. And the answer that
and Steve
up
Harvey
on the
just
board?
Stares at him first. He's just like, he bug-eyed, doesn't respond, and just stares at him. The guy goes, her butt again, like like yeah. 3 times in a row.
Tell me he did not just say that.
And then Steve Harvey just doesn't respond, just keeps staring at him, and then turns around. And the response on the board.
Yeah. Is that classic Steve Harvey, though?
On the board.
Is that classic Steve Harvey?
It is classic Steve Harvey, but like you can tell they're just hamming it up. And on the board, it pops up. The answer wasn't like her butt. It was
like her bodacious booty or something.
No, yeah, it was her dazzling dumper.
Yeah.
Adam, the answer was her dazzling dumper.
Yeah.
It said dumper?
Yeah.
Not even like derriere.
Here's the thing. They have to take that from like multiple, like dozens of people. How did dozens of people say that? Or did they just change it?
Nobody said
that. Probably had a list of options, and that was like number two. Because honestly,
they make up the numbers.
Her dazzling dumper was number two. Now, that was the first guy that responded. So when Steve Harvey looks at the girl from the other team to get her response to see which team takes it, what do you think your response would be, Adam? Would it, if dazzling dumper was number two, what's number one going to be?
Her luscious lips.
Cunt lips.
Seriously? Not like her boobs? She said something dumb, like her ears or her hands or something.
I want her penis to be completely soft.
But like
no hard cocks on my
She loses it because the guy's butt, and then basically the other team steals it all because boobs was number one.
I would have thought lips would be number one.
Oh, hold on. Uncle Hall, are you whittling a fucking dick?
I feel like he's doing it on purpose to pull out props. He has props ready for this show that he is like, I've saved these props. They're visual gags, so nobody can see most of them.
No, this is just me doing something because I'm bored. I mean, I have plenty of notes.
You have reached the maximum time permitted to record.
Are we getting less time per message?
All right. Uncle Hall, I'm gonna have to get your final thought. Your mic is terrible, and you're whittling a stick. you pulled out a Bowie knife.
Of all the notes you've taken, like what are your conclusions? Like how can we improve?
He just hung up.
Huh. All right.
Did you hang up on him?
No, I didn't hang up on him.
He hung up on himself then. He hung up.
As we just alienate all of our... Pretty soon, the only person in the chat room is going to be fucking Anchor. And then there was Anchor. That's the next episode.
Anchor
title.
Is going to stop coming to the chat because nobody else is responding to his comments.
Are you calling Michelle back at least?
All right, hang on, I'll call her back.
He might be tougher to alienate.
Yeah, Uncle Hall's thing is that he likes busting balls.
Listen, I really wanted to have Uncle Hall on the whole show, but was his mic not just the worst thing?
He was also doing it on purpose to be like obnoxious.
Well,
he kept getting up and knocking it, and then eating in the middle of it, and then at some point he had like the Trump Art of the Deal book in the shot, like, and then he moved it out of there.
I understand that this isn't a professional deal, but I mean, we got it.
Hi, you've reached Michelle's cell phone. I can't get to the phone right now, so please leave a message and I'll call you back. Thanks.
At the tone, please record your voice message. When you are finished recording, you may hang up or press pound for more options.
All right, we are back. TheLotusCast.com. So, Uncle Hall has
added himself
back. God, he's back! How does he get back?
I don't
know.
How
does he force his way into this?
I can't block callers from joining this?
All right, I reconfigured it. Is it better now?
That does sound much better.
Stop
touching the microphone.
Just sit still. Do you see me? Oh, I don't know if you can see me. But if you see me, you see how I'm not moving anywhere? I'm just in front of my mic. I'm not fucking sucking down a Barks root beer.
First off, you can't really see you. Your eyes are like the only thing in the shot.
Oh, it's a diet pib. I didn't even know they made diet pib. How do you find diet pib?
Dude, that's the only soda they sell at my school.
Nature found a way.
So nature found a way. Find diet pib, like they make fucking one crate of diet pib and they send it to your school.
Yeah, they're just like, this isn't rated for human consumption, but the school will take it.
Dude, they only sell diet soda there. They only sell Coke products. We have a deal with Sodexo.
Yeah, but I've seen Coke machines and none of them sell PIB. Like,
wait, hold on. What is Sodexo?
Sodexo is this food conglomerate, international.
Why do you know any of this?
Because I actually got to work with a few of the Sodexo corporate people when they came to our school.
Dude, I don't even know what to say to you right now.
What?
You'd know what Sodexo, a food conglomerate, is.
Yeah? Do you not?
I don't give a shit. I mean, you know why your school has Diet PIB. I would go to school, I'd be like, oh, they have Diet PIB. This fucking sucks. And I'd move on with my life.
I'm not going to lie to you, it does.
Well, it clearly doesn't discourage students from buying it.
And it's not diet.
Oh, it's regular zero. Dr. PIB? It's Dr. PIB Zero?
Mr. PIB.
Mr. PIB Zero?
No, they took the Mr. off. It's just PIB Extra.
Yeah.
I don't think I've ever had a Mr. PIB.
Well, nobody's ever heard of a PIB Zero.
It's like Cherry Coke, but always Cherry Coke.
Why don't they make a Mrs. PIB?
Wait, what? I bought Cherry Coke Zero before.
No one cares. That's the simple
thing. Yeah, but you're sucking down PIB Zero.
Oh, man. I can hear everything about
that. You do realize there's like an entire PIB recipe, like subreddit, right?
I'm sure. No, there's a subreddit for everything.
Honestly, I haven't thought about PIB until you started drinking PIB in front of me.
Dude, that was in the thermos.
So that big thermos.
So not only did you have just a bottle of Mr. PIB, you had a thermos full of Mr. PIB as well.
Yeah.
So much PIB. I feel like forever ago I saw, oh, there's a soda called Mr. PIB. I tried it and I never drank it again.
I can see that.
That was 30 years ago. That was when I was like 1 year old.
Why did you come back again? I'm sorry.
Me? I don't know.
No, really alcohol. I mean, because you're drinking and you're eating now into the microphone.
I'm not eating anything. I have cookies, but I'm not going to eat the cookies. I have more respect for this show than you think.
Yeah, he takes notes.
He took a lot of notes,
but
yes.
I have some.
So you didn't...
Alcohol, I want...
You didn't tell me what the summary of your notes was, like...
I was trying to. I even sent Matt a text message. Hey, would you like to hear my notes on large mediums? It's like
I would actually love to hear the notes.
You have reached the maximum time permitted to record.
I would love to hear the notes on large mediums.
Hold on. I got a text here. It says, want to hear my notes on large mediums.
call Michelle back.
I want to hear those notes, actually, because it could help. That was the episode that we talked about there. My script ideas.
How are they going to help? You're never going to make it.
Yeah, that's mostly the notes.
I want to hear the notes about my pitches.
Uncle Hall, you're not allowed back on the show after tonight until you work out this mic situation.
All right. I will buy a professional mic.
No, don't do that because you're not allowed back on the show.
Just come to Joe's house.
Yeah, unless you're here at Joe's house. And you can.
Hi, you've reached Michelle's cell phone. I can't get to the phone right now, so please leave a message and I'll call you back. Thanks.
Adam, do you think
this
Michelle thing is kind of funny?
Please record your voice message.
Yeah.
When you are finished,
do you think
recording,
she's even
you may hang up
or is she just like, why am I
keep
getting
options?
Voicemails?
The only part that sucks is just waiting through the voicemail message.
God, it's so funny, though.
All right.
Funny. Oh, hold on. I got a text, guys. Look, I know I'm bad, but I'm getting better. No, that's not.
Was that from David Langell?
Oh, holy shit.
No, that was from me.
All right,
let's hear
those fucking notes.
Yeah, let's hear those notes. Large mediums. Let's go.
All right, let's see. Should I do the ones for all the pitches that I wrote notes for? Because I have like two of them written notes that are extensive.
Just do them.
Yeah, just read them. Just read what you have.
All right. Let me just find the thing. All right. And just talk about something else. I'm going to mute my mic while I find it.
I thought these were ready.
Text him. Ask if he wants to hear it.
I can't mute your mic, by the way. You've got to mute yourself.
I did.
You're a little bastard.
Do you guys want me to read these notes to you? I mean, I don't have them ready, but if you call me on it, I can look for them.
Is he, like, just trying to think of some right now?
He didn't really have any notes. He's going back to listen to the whole episode.
No, I have the notes. Here they are. All right. Pitch one. Interesting concept, took in the wrong direction, needs rewriting.
Oh. Well, which do you happen to know which pitch it was?
No, I just wrote it down as pitch one.
He knows what food conglomerate serves his school.
But I don't know what pitch I wrote the notes for, yes.
Actually, you know what? This does bring up, Joe, have you put in an ounce of effort?
Yeah, an ounce.
I don't think he did.
Literally an ounce.
Oh.
Joe, I really would love to work on some sort of one of your show, like your show ideas. I really wish that you would put it together, because I think a web series would be great. I would totally come down and we'd hang out all weekend filming. I'd bring the kids, put them in the show.
That would be fun.
I'm just telling you, dude, fucking get on it and we could have a successful web series that makes no money.
Okay.
So well, now I'm motivated. Right now, what you guys do right now.
What's the pitch number two notes?
Pitch number two. Let's see. Pitch number two. Terrible concept, poorly executed, never do it again. I think that was the, like the ghost taxi?
The ghost taxi.
Well, it was ghost taxi.
Hold on.
Yeah, pitch number three, large mediums.
I'm trying to...
Pitch number three, large mediums.
I know that large mediums was the one that Joe was really pushing because, like... one of them was Alf, right? Like, one of them was just a ripoff
of
Alf.
Ralph. Ralph.
Ralph.
And it was like something Huxley. It was a very blatant ripoff of Huxley.
Adam, remember when he shit his way through pitch one and two, and then he was like, "Oh, here's the real one, which was large mediums." He really just ripped other shows.
I'm pulling up my pitches now. Hang on.
Ralph. Ralph, is it? What did Ralph stand for, though? Didn't Ralph stand for something?
I don't.
Was it like
remember.
A robot or something?
Yeah, it was like robotic.
You have reached the maximum time permitted to record. To send your message, press
it.
1 at any time. To listen to your message, press 2.
That was so stupid. It was so stupid.
Wait, here it is.
Joe, and you wonder why you get shit on. Like, you.
The Huxley family is an average American family. One day they discover that they have a visitor. He's a small, he's mechanical, he's arrogant, and he's an alien from the planet Ruboto.
And he's arrogant.
Unsure what to do, they name him Ralph for robotic alien life form.
I think Hall's notes
think
about sum it up.
The Ralph concept from me when I appeared on Blame It on the Uncle Hall.
Wait, so what were your notes about that again?
What were your notes on that one again?
Ralph. Decent ripoff. The Huxtable joke was bad.
It's Huxley, not Huxtable.
Scenes.
Probably.
Yeah, Todd Huxtable. Because it was very clearly Bill Cosby's character.
No, it was like Lenina Huxley from Demolition Man.
No. No.
Adam, do you remember how bad that was? Do you just remember? Are you taken back now to how terrible this whole thing was?
I tried to blank it from my mind, and it's all coming back
now.
And I don't even want to hear it anymore.
You wish that fucking like Tommy Lee Jones showed up with that fucking little mind eraser.
Okay, so so the first pitch was like the ghost taxi or whatever that he mentioned.
Ghost taxi.
It was called Dead on Arrival. It was about finding love in all the wrong places. And then
I wish you just burst in flames right now. I wish before me, that's what I would witness.
Pitch number two was large mediums.
Oh God.
The one was pitch number three. Was that Ralph or was that
pitch number three? Zelda Harris is living the life she's always dreamed of.
Oh yeah. Where she had to take up the two kids.
Yeah. She had to take up the two kids.
Yeah.
Isn't this ripped off from Sabrina the Teenage Witch?
No. It has Zac Efron in it.
It was the biggest. No, it was the biggest Sabrina the Teenage Witch ripoff I'd ever seen.
You know, I will have to say this, Uncle Hall. The notes and remembering these shows, you truly are the Lotus Cast historian. I mean, I don't remember any of this. I don't think anybody remembers any of this.
Yeah, I forgot most of these bitches, except for large meetings.
I really wish that Dave was here to hear all of this. Like, I think...
Call him. He won't pick up, and she won't pick up, but we can still leave voicemail.
Dave had a baby today. That's why he hasn't been here.
Dave had a baby?
Yeah.
A lot of people don't know this, but...
I saw that he said he was a proud papa, but I thought he was talking about the show.
Wait, when did he say he was a proud papa?
It was a black Jew baby.
He had a baby. He named it after one of the Sex and the City girls.
Were you guys being serious? He's a dad now? Or is
he's a dad now.
I mean, have one of you really known us to be jokers?
Oh my God, Dave had a kid.
He sent Matt and myself a picture of it earlier today. He's like, this is a baby.
He sure did.
Yeah.
No.
Show me the proof.
I can't show you a picture of it. You can just look at my forehead.
Matt, remember the conversation we had with Rochelle over the weekend where I was constantly asking for proof that she didn't forget my birthday?
And I do remember that. And nobody else in the chat or listening audience knows what you're talking about.
Exactly.
Matt, you remember this in-joke that we had this one time and nobody was around for? But it was hilarious.
Oh, boy. Oh, jeez. Man, 15. You remember being... Adam, what were you doing at 15? Were you on a cool, hip podcast taking notes?
I definitely wasn't. I was probably a lot funnier then than I am now.
You think so? I think you'd probably be funnier now than you were then. I think you were funnier then, but you really weren't.
I was definitely less miserable. I don't know. Does misery make you funnier?
I think so. Misery is pretty funny. I laugh at a lot of misery.
I don't even remember.
Mainly
15.
Joe's.
Yeah, you do love my misery.
Yeah, I was reading an article in the Washington Post. If you laugh at dark jokes, scientists apparently think you have a higher IQ.
Washington Post is fake news.
Well, obviously, but still. Assuming this isn't fake news, everyone except Joe is smart.
That sounds true.
That's proof positive right there.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
At 15, I was in a 4-H club, and doing 4-H stuff.
I think I was in the Science Olympiad. It was about science.
At 15, I'm playing varsity tennis.
They have a varsity tennis team?
Yeah, we don't have a JV team. We have a varsity team, but we still had tryouts for the varsity team for some reason.
My tennis team, we just kind of ate hot dogs around the tennis court.
Hmm. Yeah, we're actually like a powerhouse in the region.
Did you try to call Michelle? Or did you text Michelle, Adam?
I have not.
Wait, you want me to call her back again?
I mean, you know, I think we should try to get through to her.
All right, here we go.
She probably thought we gave up at this point. But, I mean, if the Lotus Cast is one thing, we're definitely persistent.
Right? I just want to give her some time to listen to the voicemail. She probably can't.
Well, I mean, the thing is she's missing so much show right now.
You know, there's probably in the back of her
no
mind.
Way,
like, what am I missing right now? I should listen to it later.
There's no way for her to go back and listen to this any other, like, she can't download it, so we have to leave these voicemails.
We can ask Anchor in the chat to send her a Facebook message. He could be our third party.
Hi, you've reached Michelle's cell phone. I can't get to the phone
right now, so
please leave a message.
We could give
you
Anchor her cell phone number. And he could call her.
At the tone, please record your voice message. When you are finished recording, you may hang up or press pound for more options.
Do you think Michelle has a home phone? Because she said, hi, you've reached Michelle's cell phone. So she made the distinction that it's a cell phone and not a home phone.
I don't think she's at home, though.
Yeah, but, like, does she have a landline?
What are you
home?
Doing, dude? What the... Why?
What are you doing? Yeah, why are you throwing things?
Are you throwing wet paper towels?
Like
balls of cotton, I think.
It looks like a softball.
Can't.
He hung up on himself? Okay, good.
I hung up on him. What
is he doing? Can you can hang up on people.
Apparently I have power.
This is probably why he can just add himself back, because there's no rules in this group chat.
There's absolutely zero rules.
Oh, he was trying to get kicked off. They finally kicked me.
Well, we have a very high tolerance for bullshit.
Yeah, evidently.
We really do. Oh, man. It's why anybody would take anything that happens on here seriously. Don't understand. So what else did we want to talk about? I know we had some tags, and we've made through most of the show with terrible audio and voicemails.
What
else we got?
We had Emma Watson had a nudie pic leak.
She did, yeah. Well, Emma Watson.
A lot of nudie pics leak.
Wow.
She was hacked, was the official line.
They're always hacked. That's what happens. After
her whole feminist controversy last week?
What was her feminist controversy?
She did that photo shoot where her tits were half out and people criticized her.
Why? If she's the one presenting it, isn't that her taking back her own femininity?
But I guess she criticized Beyonce for like the same thing.
Oh.
What, for showing titty?
For taking sexy photos.
Did Beyonce say anything in response?
I don't remember, but I just last week she was like, "Oh, I'm owning this. I'm owning my sexuality. This is feminism." But she was like, "Oh, once Beyonce did, they were just kind of trashy." Like, I feel guys are just ogling her.
I like that the spin from this article says that she was at clothes fitting and the stylist was the one taking photos, but like, Dave is the one who actually told me about these, and he linked a bunch of the photos, and it was her taking a bath.
Like, yeah.
It wasn't anything with, like, a stylist. I mean, there were a couple of her, like, trying on clothes, but, like, she was wearing clothes, like, and taking photos.
Are there any, like, close-up pussy shots?
I don't think so, yeah.
Any butthole? I don't remember. I think there was... No butthole. Just her in the bathtub with the water. I mean, I don't know. I think me looking at these, you know, I'm a terrible person. Like, if you look at these, I think you're a terrible person.
I'm looking at them right now, and I don't see any nude ones in here.
I do find that funny. Like, Adam, do you think when a celebrity nude, they're leaked, when somebody hacks their phone and releases the photos, if you look at them, are you a terrible person?
Well, it's like Ken Bone said from the second debate. You can lament the fact that they were hacked and feel bad for them, but then you can still go and look at them and jerk off.
Well, sure, but if you go and look at them and jerk off, you're a terrible person for doing so, right?
Not necessarily.
Isn't it just sort of basic human curiosity to want to look at them?
You have reached the maximum time permitted to record. To send your message...
She should be flattered, really.
Well, I think that's kind of a... I don't think that's the right assumption. She should be flattered that everybody's wanting to see her nude photos.
Well,
like,
they...
like, this is one of them, Adam. Like, one of the bath ones. Like, was that really for a stylist?
It's like a close-up titty.
Yeah, and like, you don't even really know if they're her or not.
Yeah, she doesn't even have her face in it.
Oh, that one kind of has a bit of a face. It's like her getting out of a bathtub. Like, why would you take photos of these, Emma?
I guess just the fact that you're seeing Emma Watson's titties is enough to get you going.
Yeah, I don't know. I just think if it's not, they're not yours to look at. They weren't ever meant to get out there. Like, that's you're kind of a shitty person for looking. Now, I understand the curiosity. Trust me, I'm curious. Anytime any of these things come out, I'm going to do it. But I also admit that I'm a shitty person.
Well, Trump's tax return was never meant to get out there. Are you a shitty person for finding out what's in them?
Yeah. I mean, if it wasn't meant to get out. Now, at the same time, he should have released his tax returns. Like, if what happened with his leak with Rachel Maddow, if they were recent tax returns, Like, if they were never meant to get out, like, if it was something personal that shouldn't have gotten out, then yes, you're a shitty person. Like, for in all honesty, dude, if there was some sort of hack and there was video of Trump that came out and it was him pissing on Russian chicks at a Russian hotel.
Him talking about grabbing girls by the pussy?
Yeah, like, stuff like that wasn't meant to get out. You know, in all honesty, it's shitty. Like, we shouldn't really, I don't think, be viewing that stuff. Like, that's not ours to view. That's not for us to look at. Now, I'm still going to listen to it. I'm still going to make fun of it. I'm still going to talk about it.
Hi, you've reached Michelle's cell phone. I can't get to the phone right now, so please leave a message and I'll call you back. Thanks.
At the tone, please record your voice message. When you are finished recording, you may hang up or press pound for more options.
But yeah, that is honestly how I believe. Like, you have to, it has to be fair across the board. Like, stuff like that shouldn't get out.
You gotta stick to your principles.
Yeah, I mean, it's not.
Trump himself even said that he loved WikiLeaks when he was running for president. Like, isn't that sort of a double standard then on his part to say, like, condemn the leaks now? When before he was like, I love leaks. I love how terrible it makes Hillary Clinton look.
He's not condemning WikiLeaks though.
Yeah, but it's the same thing. WikiLeaks posts leaks. Like, that's what it does. And so isn't it sort of a double standard to say I hate leaks now?
He's condemning the intelligence community for allowing the leaks to get out.
Yeah, but that's when it worked for him, when it posted stuff about Hillary Clinton, that was okay.
See, I mean,
he would still criticize the intelligence for being stupid enough to let it get out.
I firmly believe that Trump and his tax returns should be out there. Like, everybody releases their tax returns. That's what you should do. So if they leaked at this point, I wouldn't feel bad about that, because that is something that should have been done already. That's something that the American people, I feel, definitely do deserve, is that information.
It's still illegal for anyone to disclose your tax information without your permission.
I don't think it's legal illegal in that sense. Otherwise, they wouldn't They're not going to arrest Rachel Maddow for posting that information. Like,
no, they would. You would have to arrest the person who leaked it, but they don't know who leaked it.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I don't know. Like, it is kind of weird. In that situation, it's weird.
Yeah.
I feel like he should have released his tax. I mean, Adam, you don't feel like he should have released the information, the recent ones?
No, I think he should have.
Yeah. So, I don't feel like I have to
kind of trolling argue at this point
about that stuff.
But I mean, I don't even get it because they came out and there was nothing unusual in them. It was a total non-story.
I don't know that it was a non-story.
Right? Like,
I mean, the fact that they were out was the story, but like, he paid a huge amount of taxes.
He did pay a lot of taxes, but he ended up paying something like $38 million on $150 million, which makes his tax rate something like 24%, which is still low for...
That's higher than Comcast.
It's higher a business, but he is a personal, like, private person. It's lower than something like you would pay. Like, if you were, you know, paying your taxes, you're going to pay something in the 30s.
Here's the deal, dude, and you can't be mad about this. Like, you can't be mad at him if he went through the proper channels the tax break.
He did get a tax break on it. He did get a tax break on it because he paid the alternative minimum tax, which he has campaigned against. So, but he took advantage of it, which is fine because it's legal to do.
If it's legal to do it, like, I mean, there's a lot of things that if it's legal to do, people would do it. If it's illegal to do it, they wouldn't do it, you know? So, I mean, you can't really fault him for that.
It's just such a, like, I'm torn on it because it's such a stupid story. Like, he didn't release them, but didn't he release them when there was nothing...
He didn't release them just to sort of ruin her exclusive, because they released them like 30 minutes before she did.
No, I'm talking about before the election.
Oh, yeah.
I'm like,
I don't know why he's hanging on to them.
Why didn't he release them? So.
Exactly.
Which makes you honestly just trolling.
But like, the ones that got released during the election time were like from 1995. and the ones that got released last night.
You have reached the maximum time permitted to record.
2005.
Damn it, Michelle.
So like, why, you know, why are we getting such old returns? Like, isn't there anything more recent that somebody can leak? Like, I don't know.
Probably not. I mean, whatever. It is what it is. It is what it is. I'm not gonna cry over spilt milk.
I am concerned about the Obamacare replacement they're pushing right now, or Paul Ryan's pushing.
It's pretty awful.
I think like Trump isn't interested enough in it, because like, he talked a lot about it and he knows what the people want, but I feel like he's letting Paul Ryan take it over.
Paul Ryan's the one who architected it, and Trump has made a lot of promises, like, you're going to be able to get covered, you can have the doctor that you...
Hi, you've reached Michelle's cell phone. I can't get to the phone right now, so please leave a message and I'll call you back. Thanks.
When's she going
to
call us back?
I don't think she is.
At the tone, please record your voice message. When you are finished recording, you may hang up or press pound for more options.
Yeah, and I think that Trump is just sort of making a lot of promises that sort of are antithetical to what the GOP really believe. Like, they believe in less government involvement, and less, they want supposedly more competition in the marketplace, but that doesn't really...
I think they need to deal with the issue of the cost of...
is outrageously
medicine
high
before
yeah.
they worry about insurance.
The cost of healthcare is outrageously high right now. Like, it's insane. You, even with their marketplace changes and the fact that they're trying to strip out some of the Obamacare stuff, like, it just, as you get older, you're going to end up paying more in healthcare, and it's awful. Like, it's at least a third of some people's salaries without any of the tax credits that they want to take
away.
It's
like the doctors too. I was talking to my mom a couple days ago. She used to work in a hospital. Like, how someone goes in, they don't have insurance, they'll get their medicine, and they'll, like, the doctor will give them a bill for, like, the non-insured price. It'll be, like, yeah, I don't know, $10 a pill, maybe. But then they go in, they get insurance, they go in again, and they jack the price up to $400 a pill because you have insurance now, and they want to...
Yeah, because they'll get the money from the insurance.
Yeah. So that's the kind of stuff, like, it's fucked all over the place.
And it all varies state by state. So, like, there's the states that are more rural, like, healthcare costs more there because there are less options for you to choose from. There's less doctors. There's less hospitals. So there's less competition. And if you live in a city, there's actually a lot to choose from. So your healthcare might be a little bit cheaper depending on where you live. Like, the whole thing is a mess. And it's incredibly complicated. And I don't know, just this, their proposal seems pretty terrible. And they're trying to fast track it now because this is the only time that they can pass it without it getting filibustered in the Senate, because they're doing it as a budget proposal. So,
and it's like, they only have like a 52-48 advantage in the Senate.
Yeah.
The Republicans do. So there's like, if they change one thing, you lose a moderate Republican. They change another thing, you lose one of the more conservatives. So it's all,
yeah,
it's a fucked up mess of compromises.
So if they don't pass it now, while they're doing budget, then they need to get more than just a majority in the Senate. They need to get 60 votes in the Senate, which is clearly impossible. They're never going to get that.
He'll never get any Democrat votes. He said it himself. It could be great, and they'll still vote against him just because they hate him.
But, I mean, the Congressional Budget Office came out and said, like, you know, 24 million people will lose their insurance in, like, 10 more years if this goes through. And people will start having to pay a ton more money than they do now.
I mean, that's kind of misleading, because they're changing it so you're not forced to buy coverage. So people
would
lose
it. You aren't forced to buy coverage, but then people who need coverage, it's more expensive because there are less people in the pool. And that's just how insurance works in general. Like, the reason why your car insurance is as cheap as it is because everybody needs to have car insurance. If you start taking out the requirement that you need car insurance, yeah, you're going to be saving money because you're not paying into it. But the whole reason you have insurance is for in case something bad happens.
I don't know. I just hope he takes more interest in it.
I think we should wrap this up, guys. I hope we don't end final thoughts.
Do we have any
not on them shells?
Did we have any other hashtags?
I can't see what they are at the moment. Actually,
you're supposed to. Why don't you take notes like Uncle Hall?
No, I think you had Emma Watson. We got the tax returns. We got the
talked about the snowstorm thing.
Yeah. So I think we're good. Yeah. Final thoughts, Adam?
Uncle Hall, I love you, but you don't know how to be on a microphone, so I don't know. Maybe take some notes on that.
You have reached the maximum time permitted to record. Shit. To send your message, press one at any time. To listen to your message.
All right, hang on, let me call her back.
Yeah, she's got. Can't let her miss my final thoughts.
I think, Uncle Hall. I mean, he's got to get a little bit more into it. But he's on his way.
I feel like
becoming a broadcast extraordinaire.
I feel like, if I just may say, he is trying to inject his own brand of comedy by having all the props. And I feel like he was trying to call attention to some of them so that we would pause the show and talk about his fun prop.
But I mean,
the thing is,
the visual
stuff, I mean, nobody can. Visual stuff isn't there. You know, when you throw up a Trump cover to a book, it's just like, okay, there's nobody can see it except for us. And, you know,
she
hang
on.
Yeah, take notes.
Hi, you've reached Michelle's cell phone.
It's a learning process.
I can't get to the phone right now, so
but he's on the right
please
path.
Leave a message and I'll call you back. Thanks.
At the tone, please record your voice message. When you are finished recording, you may hang up or press pound for more options.
Joe, final thoughts?
Oh, well, no, I wasn't done with my final thought.
Oh, sorry. I'm sorry, buddy.
I had to wait for Michelle. Michelle, I hope you're not mad at me because I didn't do anything wrong.
Or me because I didn't do anything wrong.
And we're still friends.
Or me because I didn't do anything wrong.
And I defended you, Michelle, so... And I'm going to your party.
I'm just going to shoehorn this in there.
Are you?
No, it's the day I leave for LA.
I'm just going to shoehorn this in there because the chat liked it. But it's a shame they don't make Mrs. Pibb. And it's a shame that women can't be president, but not they can't even be a Pibb.
Wait, what?
Yeah, I fucked it up. It was better in the chat. Okay. I forgot what I said.
I was like, what? They can't be president, but they can't be a soda?
Not only can women not be president, but they can't even be Pibb.
Joe, final thoughts?
That's Mr. Pibb.
Okay. on my snow day, I watched the new XXX movie, and it was abysmal. So if you haven't watched it and you thought like maybe it's a good remake of the original XXX, it's not, so save yourself the trouble. So the action scenes were miserable. I just want to say the action scenes were miserable. There was nothing inventive about it. The only good stuff was that Nina Dobrev plays a lovable idiot in it. So
my final thought for the evening is, you know what? Words don't hurt people. People hurt people.
That's it?
I feel like there should be something about sticks and stones.
Sticks and stones may break my bones, but
I feel like you're
glue sticks to you.
You're
and
quoting that
not
like
me.
T-shirt you see, like that guns don't hurt people. I do.
Okay. I don't know, man. Hey, like it's just this silly
goose
time.
Guns don't kill people. Black people do.
Oh, Uncle Hall.
What was he saying?
His final thought is he messed up and he should have conducted himself better. Sorry.
Well,
God damn, we're just on a roll. We're just on a hot tear. Like, fucking.
Well, hopefully he makes a note of that for next time.
You know, exactly. You know what? You take these low points and you build yourself up. That's what I had to do. You know what? It just a lot of shitty things. You know, if you fuck up, guess what you do? All right, I turn this on self-reflection. I become better and move forward, move on, right? Onward and upward, right, Adam?
Right. Hall, can you put this in your notes? And from now on, March is Hurt Feelings Month on the Lotus Cast.
Uncle Hall, go ahead and call in so you can say it yourself on your terrible microphone. That's fine. Everybody's fine with that. It's your birthday. Happy birthday. Is he calling back yet?
No.
It's taking a long time to call back, buddy.
Do I have to add?
Well, he's not ready. He's got to go and...
He's got to go reassemble his microphone and... Oh, there he is. He's muted. He muted himself. And he's
It looks like you're what are you doing?
I'm sorry that you guys were upset by my actions, but I'm not upset that I did the actions. I'm just sorry that you guys I'm sorry.
Is that a Dave Harvey apology?
I'm not sorry for it.
You know,
everything except for the book was not a prop, though. Everything except for this was not a prop.
So you just showed the book for no reason?
No, the prop was this was a prop.
You said everything except the book was a prop.
Okay. No. Everything that wasn't the book.
What's the book?
So the book is the only prop. Book was the only prop. Everything else was not a prop.
You have reached the maximum time permitted to record. To send your message, press 1.
Guys, we are the Lotus Cast. LotusCast.com is where you can hear us live every Thursday night, 9 to about this time.
So no headlines?
No headlines.
Of course no headlines.
Harvey from Harvey's Headlines.
No articles?
He's the only one. He will be the only one that does headlines, and that's the way it'll be until he returns.
No, everything that wasn't the book.
You keep showing the book and not one goddamn person except the fucking... two of us looking at you right now know what you're talking about.
This was boredom.
What was? Nobody knows. It's just us.
Except you.
And you got a fucking knife, too.
The stick in this was just boredom. The stupid cotton ball was boredom. And the book was a prop.
What book? Nobody knows what book you're talking about.
There's so many props.
The art of the deal.
There's so many props. They're
guys,
all props.
You know, as we go forward and we do this, we're here to entertain you.
I know that.
Hang up on him.
All right, he's gone.
Until next week, you pieces of cunt shit. You cocksucking dumb motherfuckers that listen to this fucking show. God, how?
He's adding himself back.
How is it possible?
He's adding himself back. I'm hanging up again. He's gone.
Damn it.
Just sign off so we can get rid of
pieces
him.
Pieces of dog shit. You're all terrible, awful people that listen to this show. Until next week, go fuck your motherfucking asses.